ridden city, confined within these walls, a place without pity, a place of sin. No rules apply here among this desperate crowd. Once you go in, you are never coming out.
High five.
Thanks, man.
Now, I've got to say, there were a few mixed feelings on the silver shirt on the Star One tour. I think most people just didn't really like it. but it feels right, you know? Don't you think? I don't know, how's it look?
Actually, this time Russell had a lot going on. He was working on a new Symphony X album, and his wife was expecting a second baby. But luckily, he made some time for me. I say luckily because I think that Russell, in his style, is really, really the best in the world right now.
When I first got here, it's always a challenge with the jet lag, trying to get the right amount of sleep and, you know, waking the voice up and getting it ready to go.
Trade secrets of the masters.
But once that happened, it was just rolling and rocking, and I didn't want to stop.
I am not an evil man, I swear to you, my brothers. I've learned my lesson now, I have changed my ways. I was merely blinded by the treachery of others. Hell yeah, now I'm sure I survived, I am cured.
We're both big fans of the organic process. Of course, today it's tough, you know, there's so many samples you can use, and the digital medium is a blessing and a curse, because you can do so much, but sometimes it's better to just do the natural thing and record the real stuff. And
had this great thing with Russell where it was like, what if you do this? Yeah, and then you do that, and then I grab the guitar, and oh yeah, cool.
I'll let him establish the harmony, and then I'll just come in with like an ad-lib part. How about that? Can you live on the
Oh yeah, cool, yeah.
Something cool?
And it's a challenge, he said, because it's a lot of multiple harmonies I have to do and stuff, but
Can you live on the
almost, I loaded up for it.
That was better, yeah.
But you know, the recordings went better than expected, I think, for both of us.
We recorded for 1.5 days. And can you imagine, for 1.5 days, like 10 hours a day, singing all this high stuff, full power.
Will I dream? Or will I just die?
Ooh, that's a good die there.
I was introduced to his music through a friend here. And I was completely blown away by the album. I mean, it was a big event for me, let's say. I didn't know what it was or anything, and I put it on, and immediately I fell in love with the music, and it really spoke to me and in a really deep way. So I loved the escapism it had, the fantasy of it, the whole take you on a journey thing. With the polished Pink Floyd sort of sound, that big, open, slick sound, and I really loved it. So when he asked me to sing on one of his records, I was totally into it, and it was really cool.
All right, here we go.
Living a lie with nothing left to gain. Moments are lost like tears in the rain. Watching my dreams break down and decay. I can't give up, there must be a way.
He's like a stone wall. Nothing breaks his concentration.
Me? What?
Yeah, I was just all the time I was saying like amazing, you're the best, you're the best in the world. Yeah, I might be the best singer in the world, I'm not sure, but you were like, yeah, I know. I don't know.
That's alright, I'm human, it's cool, you know.
I think.
I could be an alien!
Or a damn dirty ape!
A damn, could be a dime! Get your stinking paws off me, you damn dirty ape!
Cool.
You damn dirty! Get your filthy stinking paws off me, you damn dirty ape!
He didn't want to do it. And now I got like eight of them.
I'm having fun with it now, so it's like, well.
Get your stinking paws! Your stinking paws off me, you dirty, stinking, damn dirty ape!
I've worked with Floor loads of times now, and it has a reason, because she's one of the best.
The very first time I was 19 years old, and not very much experience in the studio, and I was a big fan of, was, still am, but already back then was a big Arjen fan, and to be asked for that album was a huge honor.
The thing about Floor is that she is so versatile, she can sing the soft, beautiful, melodic parts, but she's like one of the best power singers in the world, I think. And if she wouldn't have been available for Star One, I mean, who would I have used, you know? I have no idea.
We started, I came in here at 10, or a little after 10. I was supposed to be here at 10. Traffic, Dutch traffic is always horrible. I guess we just go part by part. For me, it's the challenge to learn it as fast as possible. But it's always written in a very comfortable range for me, so I can just sing it very easily or adapt to what needs to happen.
Ready?
Yes. Beware the beast, there's danger in his eyes. I see the truth slipping through. Beware the beast, don't believe his lies.
He's just so good in getting the best out of somebody that I almost, today thought like, okay, he's gonna, you know, no matter how I come in here, tired or not tired or at my top or not at my top, he's gonna get the best anyway because he knows what to say, and that's a cool thing.
Zijn we er klaar voor?
Ready.
Okay, komt ie.
Now I remember you now, guess I've always known. Yes, it was me in your dream. I won't accept that we cannot change the dark future you have seen.
Kassan!
I guess another thing that maybe is the same is that I know I'm gonna love the music. That's where it in the end starts and ends with. The music is what makes the thing work or not, and make me sing good or not, that's just something I know, or just know that's gonna be all good.
Get your hands off me! Get your filthy hands off me, you damn dirty. Oh my. Oh, get your filthy camera off me, you damn dirty woman.
Normally, I record all the guy vocals myself, so the singers know what to do. But this time there were so many power songs and so many high parts, and I wanted to get across to the singers what I meant. So I had a good friend of mine called Rodney Blaze do guide vocals for me this time, which is great, you know, he really helped me out and he enjoyed doing it. Also, because he did such a great job, I wanted him on the album. And he did sing a track on CD too.
His song is called 2 plus 2 equals 5. I did it 100 times already. Still sucks.
No way.
His voice is fine, he did a great job. Don't listen to him, he's a liar. He says 2 plus 2 is 5, so hey.
Me strong, the rap means wrong, the first combine.
guys on the guitar, so I can play like Pink Floyd-y solos, you know, or soft solo melodic solos or melodies, I can do that, but the fast stuff, I just can't do it, you know. Same really goes for keyboards. I can play a few chords here and there. I can program keyboards. I'm very good with the mouse. But I can't play keyboard solos, you know, really, really, I can't do that. On the first album, Jens Johansen played most of the keyboard solos. But live, Joost van den Broek played the keyboards. And he did a great job, and he's only gotten better in the last years. So he was an obvious choice for this album. I remember I sent him like 5 or 6 songs, can you do solos on them? And like a couple of hours later I got this phone call, I'm ready, do you want me to do more? And I was like, yeah, sure, send them to me. And he sent them to me and I heard them and they were all perfect. Great sound, great playing, very virtuoso, great melodies. Just too bad that he's a real lil. He's a real lil, Joost, really. I mean, you Dutch people know what it means. Lul. Lul. Joost is a lul.
Lul!
Now I needed someone for the guitar solos. And there are a lot of great guitar players, but there's this guy in America.
Hi, I'm Gary Wehrkamp from the band Shadow Gallery, and Arjen asked me to play some solos on his latest project.
He really wanted to be on the album, you know. He really begged me.
I've been friends with Arjen for a long time, a lot longer than I thought or hoped I would be.
He did the first Star One album, and he's kind of a friend. At least he thinks he is.
He just, every year he sends me about 285 euros and says, please just be my friend, mate. Just tell the magazines we're friends, it's good for everyone. Just trust me on this one.
It's like, oh yeah, I want to be on the album, you know, it's the best thing I'll ever do.
So, I donate that money to charity, of course, and I tell a little white lie.
What? Did we get Gary's money yet? Did we get his... Okay. Actually, he's one of the best. Really, he's like one of the best players. He's virtuoso, he's fast, he's melodic, he's got this great feel, and we got his money? We didn't.
Well, here I am, and this is the solo I'm going to try to play now. Called, I'm not really sure what it's called. It's called, Digital Rain, of course. Digital Rain.
This time I decided to do